everyone. Today, we are going to make a basic car control and a dash panel as seen in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. We are also having a game jam ongoing. Make sure to check the description to know more about this. This tutorial is inspired by the Nintendo official account, so make sure to check this programmer ID to see more tutorials. Shall we get started? This tutorial covers car camera setup, basic control, and how to make a dash panel. We are going to start with setting up a car and a camera. First, we need a car. In Mario Kart, we usually see the car from the back. Add a camera and attach it to the car. Go to the settings. Set Y to be a positive number so that the camera will be on top. Set Z to be a positive number because we want to look from the back. You can adjust the number to your liking. Next, let's move our car. To accelerate, add a button A and connect it to the acceleration input. To brake, add a button B, invert nodon, and send the signal to the same input. When this receives a negative value, the car will decelerate and then stop. For steering, simply add the left stick, left right for the steering wheel. With this, you have a movable car and a camera following it. However, notice that the camera does not rotate. Let's fix this. Go to the camera settings and enable tracking characters while rotation. And yeah, now it works, as can be seen in Mario Kart. Next, we are going to add a dash panel. We are going to use an arrow for the dash panel. Put the arrow to where you want the dash panel to be. Go to the settings and only keep visible property. But right now our dash panel is floating in the air. Let's fix this. Go to the arrow's settings, rotate 90 degrees by Z axis to make it parallel to the ground, and set Y position to be 0 to make a dash panel on the ground. Now the dash panel is on the ground and our car can run over it, but it still cannot activate dash. The car has to know if it has touched the arrow or not, so add a touch sensor and attach it to the car. Go to the settings and remove visible. Set connection point to be from Y positive to Y negative so the sensor will be below the car. Update check what to check for an arrow, which is our dash panel. When the car touches the arrow, we need to send a large value to accelerate part for a short period of time. To send a signal over a short period after touching an arrow, add a timer to continuously send a signal. Send the touch output to the timer. Go to the timer settings, set output after 0 seconds, and continue output for 0.5 seconds. We want to send a large value to the accelerate part instead of 1, so we need a map nodon. Send timer output to the map, and the map output to car's accelerate part. Go to the map settings, set input range to be from 0 to 1, and output range to be from 0 to any value greater than 2. Now, when our car passes an arrow, it will speed up. Let's add a final touch and an effect to make this look even more dramatic. Add a damage effect and receive a signal whenever an arrow is touched. Let's take a look at it together. Yeah! Now it's time to add more dash panels or arrows. You can copy and paste an arrow around. Note that if you want to rotate an arrow, you cannot simply rotate it like this because the angle will be incorrect. To fix this, undo the rotation earlier, go to the settings and set X rotation to be the angle that you want. And yay! Now we have many dash panels on the ground with different angles. Hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, let me know if we should play MK8 together again. Bye bye and see you soon. I hope you will join Santa Jam. Bye!